Hello and welcome to a beautiful Oxfordshire morning. This is Wolvercote Mill Stream. It gets incredibly busy with people. It's got a bathing license on it, but everybody and his dog comes down here. In fact, more than one dog. Anyway, I thought I'd have a little go at a bit of trotting before the madness arrived. There are lots of perch, roach, dace, and as you walk down the river, you might find an odd bream, maybe even a trout, who knows. But we'll have a go at sort of trotting in any likely looking places. And right here at the bridge is where I'm going to start. Don't intend to be on the river very long because it is going to get really busy with the public. But you can't beat a bit of trotting, especially when you do it with a centre pin. Yes, it's old fashioned, it's of a bygone era, but my word, it's really good fun. And there's nothing better than being in the river doing a bit of fishing. You know, you feel at one with what you're doing. Anyway, people are starting to pull up in the car park, so let's get on with it. See a chub there. So I'm just walking down this little bit and I could see one or two chub sitting under these branches. So I put a worm to them. Nice little chublet. He's only tiny, but you know, really enjoyable. Anyway, we're popping back to see if there's a bigger one, but we like that. It's worth having a chuck everywhere you think there might be a fish, but had a couple of tiny chub, but we'll make our way down the stream a little bit further. Look at the fish out there. That is a lovely Thames. That's quite a big one, but that's a Thames bleak. That's quite a big one as they go. I've moved down to where a spot on the stream where I know there's fish, but there's a lot more water than normal. And there we are, I'm into a fish now. So I was going to talk a little bit about the rod. As you can see, it's quite tippy, but that's absolutely ideal for flicking out a small float. And we've got another species that looks like, well, it's gone now, but it looked like a hybrid. This is a 14-foot SKP concept long T float, and long T stands for long trotting, and it is designed specifically for float fishing. That's what it's designed for. What I would look for in a float rod, especially a long one, is this. It needs to be light because you're holding the rod for long periods of time. It needs to be quite tippy. The end bit needs to be quite tippy. That means the action's in the tip because you're casting reasonably light floats and you need to be able to flick them out, which I'll show you what I mean by that. It's just a flick and you're out. You need to have quite a few guides on the blank because the guides keep the line when you're float fishing. You use quite light line, so if the line sticks to the blank in any way, when it's raining or, you know, it's getting wet, you can't cast properly. So these are called standoff guides, and standoff guides are used primarily on float rods because it keeps the line from the blank. I quite like the traditional cork handle on this rod. You know, it fits and it's quite secure. It's got quite a secure reel seat, which is nice, you know, this is my centre pin. And Yeah, and you need it to be quite stiff up to that tip, but that's how it should be. That's the perfect action for a float rod. Now, you might think that 14 foot is an awful lot of rod. You know, people fish, you know, 8, 9, 10 foot rods, and certainly 10, 11 foot float rods, especially on commercials, are ideal. But this isn't a commercial, and you need a little bit more control over your tackle. You know, you need to control this float as it makes its way down the stream. And that could be the same if it was a waggler. It doesn't have to be just a stick float. And for that, you do need that extra length. For me, I'm not the biggest guy, and I'm not particularly sort of strong, and I haven't got big wrists. So 14 foot is sort of the optimum sort of length for me. And if you, you know, fancy having a go at it, I would say 14 foot is the perfect length. That's nearly the end of our day. See, why don't they go down on the river? Like I said at the start of this thing, time was always of the essence, and so it's proven, because as you can see behind me, the first of the day's wild swimmers has decided that rather than walk down to the river and disturb nobody, it's far better to get in next to me and mess the fishing up. Ultimately, that's not going to do it a lot of favours. So we're going to have another couple of casts, and I think that'll do. But I've still really enjoyed it. I mean, it's one of the most fun ways to fish for me. Really enjoy just, you know, it's really is fishing at its sort of most purest. So I'm going to have another 5 minutes, but I think that will do.